So today we're going to talk a little bit about Preflow Core Base and what's included. Mostly it will be things like Preflight and Impose that people are interested in here. There's also enhancement of images. There's different ways to submit files down to Preflow Core, including the web client, JDF, JMF, hot folders, CLI or command line interface. You can save files or print files down to the printer with job ticketing. You can control finishing as well at the printer level. And then you can submit down LPR. Taking a look at the preflight within Preflow Core, we can come up into the job management status window to submit a job through the web browser by just clicking up here and saying submit job. We pick the file we want to take a look at, hit open, and then we pick our workflow destination, in this case, preflight. And the job will come into Preflow Core. In this case, it got paused because there's an error with the job. You can come over here and click on the preflight report itself and just take a look and see what was wrong with the job. We can see that there was fonts not embedded on 22 matches on 3 pages, pages 1, 3, and 8. When we click on these numbers here, it'll actually bring us down to the errors themselves. It's highlighted. It can show us exactly what the report says it is. So this is Bembo SC 20 point was not embedded into this PDF. And it's going to lead to some issues. So maybe it goes down to the rip and gets substituted in something like an aerial, or maybe it goes down to the rip and just errors out, right? Maybe it doesn't rip at all. There's another error on this page, and it looks like this is a low-res image. This one has 150 pixels per inch, and I think we have the threshold set at 250. We can swing into Preflow Core and just take a look at the preflight itself. So just taking a component over here and dragging it onto the workflow screen, you can see it's very easy to put a preflight into a workflow. You can double click on this and we can make our settings. So we can do a preflight check. We can make sure the fonts that are embedded properly. We can check for color or grayscale images and then set our threshold to be exactly what we want. And then we can hit save here. There's a lot more inside of the preflight in terms of what you can check for with the Callus profiles. Very customizable and easy to use. Moving on to the imposition within Preflow Core, probably my favorite part about the program itself. We'll drop that booklet into an imposition workflow. But then beyond booklets, we'll use some flat examples as well. So we've got a business card, a 5x7 postcard, as well as a rack card. We'll drop those into a hot folder. So go to Preflow Core and actually look at the results here. We can see we've got those flat cards. Here's that booklet, and we'll look at results. You can see Preflow Core did the imposition. The pagination is correct for us automatically. Here's page 1 and page 8 together, and then so on and so forth. Looks like everything was imposed properly. And then we take a look at the flat cards. Here's that 5x7 postcard. And Preflow Core laid that out for us as well. The great part about the imposition in Preflow Core is that it's rules-based. It's not template-based like a lot of the other imposition softwares. So depending on the incoming file, the results will be different. So it's going to interrogate that file, understand what the file size is, and then put it up as many as possible up on that sheet. And then it's going to pick the most appropriate sheet size as well, trying to eliminate waste. And here's that last one, which is a business card. You can see here that the Dutch row over on the right-hand side. This might not be perfect for everybody. If you have a cutter slitter within your building, but because Preflow Core is rules-based, you can set those rules so that this isn't an option, right? You can understand that it's a business card, and then you can use your business card template layout for your cutter slitter. We can also do things like barcoding for the cutter and slitter to make it even a little bit more efficient. If you have any questions, please reach out to the Preflow Core team or your sales rep.